The 24th of March 1989 was a special day. It was the first Friday after the centenary of the community, and Hazrat Khalifa Tulmasi IV delivered his sermon.
Aaj jo aap mere saath khutba juma pad rahe hain, khutba sun rahe hain ya juma pad rahe hain, aapko main ye itla, khushkun itla bhi deta hoon ki is waqt is awaaz ko मॉरिशस के अहमदी भी सुन रहे हैं और जर्मनी के अहमदी भी सुन रहे हैं। ये वो सदी का पहला खुतबा है जिसको आसमानी रसलो रसाइल के ज़रिए से, जिसको सैटेलाइट हुकअप कहते हैं, सबसे पहले मॉरिशस की जमात ने सुनने का इंतज़ाम किया और अब मुझे इतला मिली है कि जर्मनी की जमात ने भी इस खुतबे को बराह रास्त सुनने का इंतज़ाम किया हुआ है।
That further developed and it progressed into a way whereby 24 countries joined that group of countries who were listening to his Friday sermon through the telephone. In 1991, Huzoor graced the Jalsa Salana of Qadian Darul Aman. On that historic occasion, the addresses of Huzoor Rahimullah were relayed throughout the globe via satellite telephone link.
This laid foundations for a new form of communication and reached a new height on the 31st of January 1992.
Aaj ka din Ahmadiyyat ki tareekh mein ek bahut hi mubarak din hai. Ye juma jamaat ki dusri sadi ki tareekh ke aagaaz mein ek bahut hi azim sang-e-meel nasab kar raha hai aur jamaat ko जमा होने के एक नए दौर में दाखिल कर रहा है। बनी नौ इंसान की तारीख में पहली मर्तबा हज़रत मसीह मौऊद अलैहिस्सलाम के इस आजिज़ ग़ुलाम और खलीफतुल मसीह को ये तौफीक मिली है कि ऐसा खुतबा दे रहा है, ऐसा जुमा पढ़ा रहा है जो एक बहुत ही ताकतवर बर्रे आज़म के एक किनारे से दूसरे किनारे तक सौती लिहाज से भी पहुंच रहा है और तस्वीरी लिहाज से भी पहुंच रहा है।
हजरत खलीफा तुलमसी IV's vision to lead the community to new heights manifested itself in the creation of a TV channel that would connect the community to their beloved leader. Initially, his Friday sermons were transmitted in Europe only, but on the 21st of August 1992, the transmission started spanning four continents. Through the blessings of this new medium, the barriers of distance were broken. And the community came together at the hand of Hazrat Khalifa Tulmasi IV at the annual conference in
1993. मुख्तलिफ ज़ुबानों में एक शख्स के हाथ पर बैत कर रहे हों और वो शख्स हज़रत अब्दस मोहम्मद मुस्तफ़ा सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के एक गुलाम का अदना गुलाम हो। आज मैं आपसे अहद बैत लेता हूँ, हाथ बढ़ाइए। अशहदु अल्लाह इलाहा
The international bath took place during the Jalsa. That event actually was telecast live throughout the globe, and that's how this concept of Huzoor Rahimullah was actually materialized. And that was, I think, the milestone, that was the turning point from where Huzoor wanted to progress forward, carry that momentum forward.
This momentum took MTA to a new level, and on the 7th of January 1994, MTA started its daily transmission from its Earth station in London.
Alhamdulillah, ke aaj wo juma ka din aaya, jiski bahut der se dil mein tamanna thi aur ek muddat se intezar tha, ke aaj khuda ke fazl ke saath international Ahmadiyya Muslim television ka बाकायदा आगाज़ हो रहा है। वो जो जुमा का खुतबा पहले हर जुमे सुनाया जाता था, वो अगरचे इसी टेलीविज़न के ज़रिए था, लेकिन एक रोज़मर्रा की सर्विस के तौर पर अभी ये जारी नहीं हुई थी। बस अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह कि जिस जो खुशखबरी मैंने मॉरिशस की सरज़मीन से दी थी, आज इंग्लिस्तान की सरज़मीन से ये ऐलान करने की तौफीक मिल रही है कि आज से बाकायदा मुस्लिम टेलीविज़न अहमदिया की रोज़ाना सर्विस का आगाज़ हो चुका है।
हुज़ूर रहमतुल्लाह, I think I could always feel that whatever we talked about, whether it was about the commercial side of the contracts, the satellite contracts, very complex satellite contracts, whether it was about the technological aspects of the television, of the broadcast industry, of the satellite transmissions, I always found that he was one step ahead. I don't know how. To even this day, I don't know. But he was.
Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV maintained a deep interest in the administration and the overall supervision of MTA. Under his guidance, the channel progressed rapidly, starting its 24-hour service across the globe on the 1st of April, 1996. He personally initiated new programs and participated in countless broadcasts, ranging from lectures, sermons, question and answer sessions, to teaching the Holy Quran and homeopathy. Catering for a variety of languages for young and old, he ensured that MTA sought to provide an education and training medium unrivaled in history. He used to love children and would sit among them and tell them stories, and at the same time, teach them some very important lessons in life. His charismatic personality graced the screens of millions. Suddenly the boundaries were shrunk and his message could reach them no matter where in the world they were.
ये अजीब दौर आ गया है, लम्हा लम्हा की खबर हर जगह पहुंच रही है। जमात अहमदिया की आलमी बरादरी एक खानदान बन गई है। एक हाथ पर इकट्ठे होकर ऐसे इत्तेहाद का नजारा कभी पहले किसी ने नहीं देखा था। क्या
जर्मनी हजूर?
हाँ, जर्मनी वाले कहते हैं, हम भी जर्मनी तो यहाँ बैठा हुआ अक्सर। माशाल्लाह, जिम्बाब्वे से भी, सोचें जरा कहाँ जिम्बाब्वे, कहाँ ये दुनिया। लगे बदल से जापान से आ गया है। कादियाँ वाले भी बोल रहे हैं कि नहीं अभी तक? अच्छा, अल्लाह अकबर, जमात हाय अहमदिया अरब जिंदाबाद, जमात अहमदिया अजमान व शारजा जिंदाबाद, गैम्बिया से भी माशाल्लाह। देखें कहां कहां से आज आलमी राबता है, इकट्ठे बैठे हुए। बरादरी कितनी अजीम है ये। कभी दुनिया में ऐसा वाकया हुआ है? कभी हुआ है ये वाकया? मसीह मौत की दुआएं हैं जो अर्श पर सुनी गई, मोहम्मद मुस्तफ़ा का एजाज है जो आज जाहिर हो रहा है।
Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV was an internationally acclaimed thinker and scholar of comparative religion. He was a prolific writer and author of many scholarly works. In his books, he dealt with social, political and moral issues facing the world. Some of his books include Murder in the Name of Allah, Gulf Crisis and the New World Order, Universal and Moral Values, Politics and World Peace, Islam's Response to Contemporary Issues, An Elementary Study of Islam, Christianity, A Journey from Facts to Fiction, Absolute Justice, Kindness and Kinship. His masterpiece was Revelation, Rationality, Knowledge and Truth. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV was a great poet. His collection of Urdu poetry, Ghulam-e-Tahir, was also published during his lifetime. He had a profound understanding of religious scriptures. He delivered lectures and held classes to teach the meaning of the Holy Quran. For the benefit of mankind, he also translated the Holy Quran in a fluent, simple and easy to understand form. His question and answer sessions were a testament to his knowledge. He was asked all kinds of questions on all kinds of subjects, whether it was science or religion, moral or social issues. He was never short of a reply.